Yes, return. You know, I should return. I don't think there's any reason. Any soldier. Oh, wrong way. Never mind me. I don't think there's any reason to talk to the rest of the crew at this point, just Garrus. Although. Maybe I want to sell all this crap.
Looking for supplies?
Looking to sell.
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
Let's see what I've got. Now I assume all the stuff here is stuff that we're not currently holding. So, or here, actually, anyway. Don't worry about these amps another time. I'm holding on to the anti-thorian gas just for fun. Omni tools. Sure, I can't wear that. Rich off this guy here. Let me look at the stuff. Biotic amps. Polaris 6. We don't find these things very often, so I usually just... Yeah, I can sell all this crap. I can sell this armor too. I don't know about the Omni tool because I can't even look at them. So,
looking for supplies?
Let's see what you've got.
You bet, Commander.
What you got? Okay, the amps I will sell then. And the medium armor. Hooray. Okay. We got for sale? Anything good? Is this all the stuff I just sold you? Sniper rifle? What is this? I can't compare. Well, yeah, I can. I'm looking at a shotgun. 266. Well, that's chump change at this point. We have what? A little over 3.5 million credits. Any other shotguns? That's stinky. Okay. I'll get that. Assault rifle. Hell yeah. Getting that. New pistol. Hope I was looking at that right. Find out if I was doing it right. Oh yeah. The HMWP6. Spectre Master Gear. Oh yeah. It's a special Spectre weapon. That's pretty cool. Master Spectre gear consists of prototype technology not yet available through other manufacturers. That's pretty cool. I like that. Not yet available. But I got it, baby. This is the same thing. HMWSG-7. Spectre Master gear. Boom. Nice. Okay, so I can sell the shotgun and pistol now. I wonder if anyone else can even put on that stuff, which is just me, because I'm the Spectre.
Looking for supplies?
That's a good question.
Let's see what you got.
You bet, Commander.
You betcha. Where's that pistol? And a shotgun. I got two exoskeletons. He has an older amount of cipher tools, so I'll get rid of that. Pretty safe there. Blue wire tool one, we have two of them. Two of these. Okay. Oh, Rex. I mean, Garrus, sorry.
Commander, I hear you dealt with Dr. Salion.
You hit right.
I wish you'd taken me with you.
I'm sorry.
You'll be glad to know he's dead.
So I heard. It's just, I've been waiting to nail him for years. Well, at least he's dead.
Hmm. He's pissed. I'm sorry, Garrus. I forgot. I wasn't thinking. I just want to finish the quest.
Commander, I wanted to thank you.
Thank me?
What for, Garrus?
For everything. Taking me with you, letting me be part of your team. I've learned a lot. Thanks, Commander.
You bet.
You're welcome, Garrus.
Almost sounds like he was ready to bid us farewell.
Never a dull moment with you, Shepard.
You ever go on any missions like ours before?
Saving the galaxy from certain destruction? No. But I've had my share of adventures.
Adventures?
Do you remember any that stick out?
A few. I remember one time I was hired by a Volus diplomat. What an ass.
This is new. What diplomat?
I guess even politicians have need of mercs from time to time, huh?
Time to time. If it wasn't for politicians, I'd be out of work. They're always looking for ways to get ahead. This one was no different. He wanted me to erase his past. Get rid of an old friend who knew too much. Huh. His old friend turned out to be an Asari commando.
I can see why that might give you pause.
What? No. Alina and I were old friends. Sort of.
Sort of?
We met when we were both contracted to kill the same Turian. Either of us wanted the other one to get him first. We spent more time fighting each other than tracking that Turian.
Huh. She was a merc?
An Asari commando mercenary. That's unusual, isn't it?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
I wouldn't say it's unusual. Mercs come in all shapes. Anyway, when I told Alina about the diplomat's contract, she and I had a good laugh about it.
And then what?
So what'd you do?
Well, I wasn't going to lose the contract, but I respected Alina. In the end, I let her pick the location where we'd fight. She chose some old Solarian space station overrun with mercs and smugglers. That way we didn't have to worry about hurting any innocent bystanders. She always was a bit of a softy.
What about the fight?
What happened on the station?
What didn't happen? For 2 days I chased her through that station. Used my entire store of ammunition. Had to kill a bunch of mercs and use their crap weapons. By the third day, the station was barely holding together. The mercs were dead or gone. Life support was failing. But I had her. She'd locked herself in the med labs. She was trying to patch herself up. Damn tough, that one. Then just when I thought I had her, the station's core went critical. Barely made it back to my ship in time.
Did Alina get out?
I assume the Asari commando didn't make it.
I watched the station from a distance. I never saw her leave. And when that place blew, there was nothing left larger than a Turian's right nut. So I headed back to the diplomat to give him the good news and collect my pay. But before I got halfway there, Alina sent me a message. Better luck next time. Now, I'm not superstitious, but if someone can survive that, well, they deserve to live. At least for a bit longer.
And, Volus, diplomat?
What about the diplomat? He wanted her dead.
I told him the truth. Alina was still alive and she was really pissed. I told him if he wanted to live, he'd need me around to protect him.
Huh. Told him that?
And he believed you.
He kept me on as his personal guard until he died. Natural causes.
Great laugh.
Easiest job I've ever had. A little boring, but credits are credits.
That's great. I assume this stuff is all the normal stuff and questions and answers as before.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
I love his little stories. Oh, we got a codex thing. Oh, codex. Nope. Oh, we got points to do. Then we gotta check codex. Put pistols. Can't upgrade the others right now. Which one is Codex? Krogan biology. The Krogan evolved in a lethal ecology. Over millions of years, the Grimm struggled to survive larger predators. virulent disease and resource scarcity on their home world, Tuchanka, turn the lizards into quintessential survivors. Perhaps the most telling indicator of Tuchanka's lethality is the Krogan eyes. Although they are a predator species by any standard definition, their eyes evolve to be wide-set, as in earth prey species like deer and cattle. Krogan eyes have a 240-degree arc of vision, better suited for spotting enemies sneaking up on them than for pursuit. Physically, the Krogan are nigh indestructible, with a tough hide impervious to any melee weapon short of a molecular blade. While they feel pain, it does not affect their ability to concentrate. They have multiple functioning examples of all major organs, and can often survive the loss of one or two of any type. Rather than a nervous system, they have an electrically conductive second circulatory system. A Krogan can never be paralyzed. They may lose some of this fluid, but it can be replaced by the body in time. The hump on a Krogan's back stores water and fats that help the Krogan survive lean times, really. Large humps are a point of pride. Being well-fed implies the Krogan is a superior predator. The most widely known biological feature of the Krogan is their incredible birth rate and rapid maturity. Once freed from the hostile cauldron of Tuchanka, the Krogan population swelled into a numberless horde. Only the genophage kept them from outbreeding the combined council races. Now the rare Krogan females capable of bringing a child to term are treated like strategic resources. Warlords will trade them at diplomacy or, more frequently, fight wars over them. Yeah, speaking of strategic stuff, we're getting really good at diplomacy, aren't we? Dealing with threats, people in a non-lethal way. It's pretty cool. Ashley.
Commander? What's your opinion of the last mission?
Gotta admire those colonials. That's about the worst place for a colony I've ever seen.
Talked about this, right?
Given the option, I'd get the hell out of Dodge.
Do you have a few minutes to talk? One-on-one?
I should get back to my duty, Skipper. Rifles don't maintain themselves. Not yet, anyway.
Huh.
Dismissed, Chief.
Ma'am.
Alright. Well, I figured Rex had something new to say. Then so would other people.
Hey, Shepard. You need something?
We've talked about all this.
I should go.
See you later.
Oh, yeah. Freaking with the doors here. How these things appear and disappear. Wait, I don't want to go that way, do I? Do I hear? So awkward.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
We're all in for the duration. You can count on everyone to do their duty.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
This lighting with the glistening skin drives me insane. I think these are my own quarters. Okay. our sorry friend. Liara, yay!
I get the feeling you want to ask me something, Commander.
Yeah, let's talk.
I like talking with you, Liara. No matter what the subject.
You have been very understanding with me, Shepard. Very patient. I appreciate that.
Good.
I know there are some strange beliefs about my people. I am familiar with the legend of Asari promiscuity. But those rumors have little basis in fact. When one of my people joins with an individual from another species, it is a very deep and spiritual exchange. We do not enter lightly into a union.
Is this a proposition? spiritual exchange, you say?
You make it sound almost mystical.
A true union goes far beyond an ordinary melding. It is a connection that transcends the physical universe.
Really?
Two become one. Thoughts and senses merge, identities intertwine. Memories and emotions weave themselves together, becoming entangled in a single, rapturous whole. It is unlike any other experience. In some cases, it can be a truly life-changing event.
And I'm torn between these two answers now. I'm intrigued. Sounds weird.
Sounds amazing. Are you saying...
No! Oh, no. I am not very good at this, am I? I'm sorry, Shepard. I am trying to explain why I have been so... reserved. The union is more than just sex. It is the lifeblood of my species, the way we Asari evolve and grow as a society. That is why I have never... that is why we must choose our partners with great care.
Well, there's certainly no rush. I'm not going anywhere unless, Saren kills me.
I want you to be absolutely sure about this, Liara.
I am only 106, barely an adult by Asari standards, and I spend most of my time absorbed in my research.
Only 106.
I never really thought about it. Not until I met you. You are very special to me, Shepard.
Aww.
But with all that's happened, Saren, the Geth, the Reapers, I do not know if we are ready for this.
We are? Is that the right answer? We are. We are.
I'm ready. If you are.
Eager is not the same as ready, Shepard. There is too much at stake.
So
we need
funny.
To put aside our personal feelings and focus on stopping Saren.
All right.
I wish it did not have to be that way. But we all have to make sacrifices. Let's talk about something else.
She is so coy. we've already asked her about culture and Benezia, so... Yeah, that's all I was basically interested, so I just wanted to bone you. I'm gonna go now.
I should go.
Goodbye, Shepard.
funny. Okay. Codex. It's biology. So this is new? Asari have a robust cellular regenerative system. While they do not heal faster than other species, Asari are known to reach 1,000 years of age. Although Asari have one gender, they are not asexual, and Asari produces two copies of her own genes to her offspring. The second set is altered in a unique process called melding. During melding, an Asari consciously attunes her nervous system to her partner, sending and receiving electrical impulses directly through the skin. The partner can be another Asari or an alien of either gender. Effectively, the Asari and her partner briefly become one unified nervous system. This unique means of reproduction is the reason Asari are talented biotics. Their evolved ability to consciously control nerve impulses is very similar to biotic training. Asari believe that their offspring acquire the best qualities of the father from the melded genes, but evidence is anecdotal. Asari pass through three climacteric life stages marked by biochemical and physiological changes. The maiden stage begins at birth and is marked by the drive to explore and experience. Most young Asari are curious and restless. The matron stage of life begins around the age of 350. though it can be triggered earlier if the individual melds frequently. This period is marked by a desire to settle in one area and raise children. The matriarch stage begins around 700 or earlier if the individual melds rarely. Matriarchs become active in their community as sages and counselors dispensing wisdom from centuries of experience. While each stage of life is marked by strong biological tendencies, individuals do make unexpected life choices. For example, there are maidens who stay close to home rather than explore, matrons who would rather work than build a family, and matriarchs who have no interest in community affairs. Cool. Yeah, that's all she wanted, what we wanted to talk to her about. See ya. Kidding, of course, but we had no other option, actually, so. Kinda seems that way, doesn't it? Alright. Now we can go to the Marine Sea Cluster and do these two things, or do the Geth activities. I will, yeah, we'll find out next time what the hell I do. Thanks for watching, see you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.